cookies in ASP.NET. In ASP.NET, cookies are useful for storing small amount of data and information which is frequently changed information on the client side. For cookies are using to understand whether browsing history and browser data which is used for the data or earlier used that particular browser or windows of that user. To maintaining such information, some of the application vendors will use for generating the cookies and using, and also saving some sense, storing the information about the metrics and analysis purpose of these data. For cookies, we have to use at the client side only for saving the data of the about the information. Some of the persons may, the end users may accept the cookie, and some of the persons may not accept the cookie. While that time, if we are implementing stringently to aware and understand by using the cookies, if the cookie is able to access, then only the, if the application is able to continue the process, then it may be the user is not, if he is not accessing the cookie, then it won't be work. The functionality of the application is perfectly. That all you have to aware to start beginning with the cookie generation and maintaining. And some of the cookies are persistent cookies are there and non-persistent cookie. Persistent cookie is then permanently it will be clear once the application is terminated and will not have the more time and it will be destroy the things. In non-persistent model, it will be stayed the client side and it will be stored some situation information and it will have some days of the expiry date. Then only it will be clear the information of regarding that. And there is an having an advantages and disadvantages, both are there with this. Can configure and expiration rules we need to define while creating the cookie. Cookie can expire when the browser sessions ends and it can exist indefinitely on the client computer. And no server resources are required to use the cookies and stored, it will be stored on client side, either machine of desktop or laptop, whoever the device. And read by the server after a post. Disadvantages, most browsers place 4096 bytes limit on the size of the cookie. Modern browsers will increase this, whereas the limitation of the size of the data to be stored on the client side is a small bit of text file like. And potentially security risk, if sensitive data is stored on these cookies at a client side place. As in a developer or a programmer, you have to aware which parameter you are going to be storing to read for the later levels. If it is in a sensitive, maybe I am open the my query that location path I have identified independently my local machine and I have opened that cookie text file. If I found the text of any sensitive data, I may try to find some other systems and the user's data. Likewise, the very much difficulty to have an security aspects. The sensitive data is no more not required to store on cookie sessions. And the persistent cookie is what we have discussed right now, and the creation of the cookie we will see at a glance at the simple steps. Now see here, HTTP context have a HTTP cookie name, I have taken cookie, and HTTP cookie is in a BG data, the background of the data I have inserting into the cookie. And the cookie dot value, you have to specify any of the value. I have a selected that color dot selected value. And the cookie expires, I have to define the parameter dead time dot now is an add hour is means 1 hour to time to expire that cookie. I have mentioned that. And you were wish to mention any time over there like 15 minutes, 30 minutes or 10 seconds, 10 minutes likewise. You can specify the time of the expiry of that cookie and response dot set cookie of this particular cookie by adding the value, the main data, the value and expiry date time and responsive to setting the cookie. Likewise, you can set at browser side cookies. Later time, you can read the cookie by using these parameters to read the cookie and have the values to use to reusability at the client side only. Without depending on the server request and server round trips, you will have a data by reading the cookie and you will have it. It's one of the state management technique where you can implement client side itself to handle the data in a good manner and good way to get in a speedy process and speedy application execution and performance to be huge of the view of the performance of the application level. I hope you better understand about this. Any clarifications and regarding this cookie sessions and all, you will comment us and let us know the clarification. We will give you in help of the sessions, definitely with the help of comment and all emails and all. Thank you for watching this session. Thank you.